Welcome to our project. This is a video presenting our research
entitled Java Plum, Syzygium Cuminae Peel Extract, and Purple Mangosteen, Garcinia Mangostana Rind Extract as dyes for dye-sensitized solar cell.
Oh, and I'm Justine Dye.
I'm Keisha Danolo. We know the title's pretty long, but we promise you'll understand why.
Global warming is now a worldwide problem. Schreiber in 2007 said that it can destroy a lot of homes, businesses, infrastructures, and disrupt cable lines. Since we humans are the ones destroying it, we must also be the one to repair it. Fortunately, according to NREL 2013, countries have increased interest in renewable energy, which are resources that constantly renew themselves. Solar, wind, geothermal, and hydro are examples of renewable energy.
It is a young technology, and little study have been made about it compared to the standard solar cell. For now, we have decided to study one of the solar cell's main components, which is the dye. According to Gratzel in 2003, the dye must be organic and is used to absorb and conduct solar power for the solar cell itself. For the study, we will test the effectiveness of the Syzygium Cuminae Peel Extract and Garcinia Mangostana Rind Extract as dyes for the dye-sensitized solar cell.
Now that you have a background on the problem being discussed in the study, let's move forward to the methods we are going to use.
We would gather the materials which consist of Java Plum Peel, Mangosteen Rind Extract, ethanol with 95% concentration, and the DSSC. We would then prepare the extracts, make the DSSC, and test it to artificial light and natural light, and we would gather the data and test it to the statistical analysis.
To prepare the extract, you need to collect the Java Plum Peel and Mangosteen Rind from the fruit. Rinse with distilled water, gather them to dry in a sanitized container for days. After drying, blend it until finely ground and dilute it in a 12 ml of 95% concentrated ethanol mixed with 1 ml of water.
In order to create a dye-sensitized solar cell, you must have two layers, namely the anode and cathode respectively. The anode is made using a conductive glass light. They prepare titanium dioxide, or the TiO2 solution, which will then be poured onto the glass plate, will be spread evenly. After these procedures are done, the glass plate with the solution was annealed.
The Java Plum Peel Extract and the Mangosteen Rind Extract were squeezed into a cheesecloth. The annealed glass plate was then soaked to the dye solution, and then rinsed first with water, and then twice with cathode is made using a piece of conductive glass light with graphite spread across its surface using a graphite pencil. It was then heated for 30 minutes at 450 degrees Celsius. The prepared electrolyte solution was dropped onto the annealed titanium dioxide glass slide and spread evenly. It was then clipped with a graphite-coated conductive slide using two binder clips. They were attached to both ends of the glass slide.
Before the trials, a multimeter was connected to the DSSCs using an alligator clip and two wires. The red wire, or the positive electrode, was attached to the slide opposite the dye-soaked slide. The black wire, or the negative electrode, was attached to the slide soaked in Java Plum and Mangosteen dye. The voltage and current output were measured and the data was obtained from the experiment.
The researchers used a t-test to sample assuming unequal variances using the program Microsoft Excel 2013. There are two experimental variables, which are the Java Plum or the Syzygium Cuminae and the Mangosteen, the Garcinia Mangostana Rind Extract, and one negative control group, which is a solar cell with no dye added to it. The results of the power outputs were used to determine the differences between the power outputs taken and the tests.
This is the end of our study. We hope you learned a lot. Thank you for listening. For comments, suggestions, violent reactions, please comment below.